It's running, but...
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Thank you so much. Let us please stand together and sing together song number 312. Sorry, that would be 310. Table of Plenty.
Oh,
Oh. urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received. With all humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all, through all, and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christ.
Good evening, everyone. So in the gospel, we see how the Lord, or we learn that he went to the other side of the lake, the other side of the Sea of Galilee. And many people followed him on foot from different towns. And after arriving, the Lord went up to a mountain top, raising his eyes. He saw that many people had gathered together. He heard, he asked Philip, with what we will buy bread so that these people can eat. And Philip responded, saying that they would need a lot of money to buy enough food for so many people. Then here comes the brother of Peter, Simon Peter. And he intervened, saying, "There is a boy who has 5 loaves of barley, bread, and 2 fish. But what is that for so many people?" So Jesus ordered them to get the people to sit down on the ground. And it was then that he performed this great miracle of the multiplication of the bread and fish. More than 5,000 people ate there, and they were all satisfied. If you go to this place where the Sermon on the Mount happened, close by is Roman Hill, and down below is the church of the multiplication of bread and the fish. And the area to this day is still untouched. You can still see Rolling Hills. It's so beautiful with white flowers around. And you can just imagine that time when the Lord was with them during this sermon about this multiplication of bread and fish. From the time of Jesus up to our times, we are still worried about many things and not really trusting in God in everyday life. Life probably changed a lot, but we are still asking these many questions in life. Anxiety, worry, and other difficulties that we encounter in this life. To whom could we go here on earth who would be capable of multiplying any form of food, peace in the hunger of the people of the world as Jesus did? We are all conscious of the hunger of many people in many countries, even here in our own country. There are still people who are hungry. As we see, also thousands of people trying in one way or the other, government organizations trying to remedy this hunger problem. But it seems it's just a continuing problem. Seems no solution to these things. The miracle of the multiplication of the bread and fish should make us raise our eyes and look to God. Because only with God's help and our own generosity that we will help those who are in need. So let us not forget with the help of God and give it a little more. We will help those who are hungry and those who are in need. Last week I went to have a tour of this new Auburn Interfaith Group Closet. It's a new building and it will arrange a food closet down at the other way.
also was there. Bring whatever you can, my soul. Few of our Christians were there, helping run the operation of the food closet. And I learned people really donated their time and their resources, sharing whatever they had to this beautiful ministry of feeding the poor, helping those who are in need. And they said that they gave 3 days of life because the reality is we can't help everyone. But whoever goes there, they give 3 days of supply, depending on how many numbers and the family. And their observation is that those our members who are in need probably are ashamed to go there and ask for help. We all can help by recommending those that we see that really in need. Even our own members, we should not be ashamed to ask help if we need help. We are also giving others the opportunity to be generous, to be kind to others. And sometimes it's a test on us. If we see those who are in need, what do we usually do? If we cannot give because we don't have or we don't have the resources and means, we can pray for those people that God will send somebody to help those who are in need. Many say that the needs still exist to this time, even this miracle in the past happened, and it seems the Lord is not always there when there is need. But we are the continuation of the mission of Christ. We are the hands, feet, and eyes of Jesus to continue the ministry that He started, helping those who are in need, feeding those who are hungry. And we can say that the only one that can really resolve this hunger is one that Christ Himself. We need Him. And whatever we do in this life, we need Him. He is the one that is the provider of everything. And everything that we have comes from God. And so if we pray, we ask the Lord to help us in our many needs also. And He will grant us in His own time. More so than we ask for others. You know the word pray as kind of acronym. How do we pray? P is to praise God first before we ask. Sometimes we just directly say, Lord, give me this. We don't even say praise to our Father in heaven. So praise Him. Then, letter R, remember the things that God has given you. Sometimes we forget to say thank you, Lord, for all these blessings that we have. We just ask right away. The letter A is to ask for others. Before you ask for yourself, ask for others. For those people that are entrusted to you, your family, your relatives, your neighbors, for our country. Then the letter Y is you. So praise. Remember the things you have done, ask for others, then for yourself. That's prayer. That's how to pray. And He will usually grant us whatever we ask in this life. So let us not fall into the error of thinking that we ourselves can fix these problems of the world without God's help. Sometimes we rely on our own resources, our own strength and power. But the truth is, only God can help us. Without Him, we can do nothing. In the Gospel of Bread of Life, the Lord, the Bread of Life, will always provide us for anything. He took the little he had that time, 5 loaves and 2 fish, giving thanks to our Heavenly Father, distributed to all, and everyone were satisfied of their hunger. You know, when I was in the seminary, our mentor priest also told us that probably because people know they are following the Lord, they don't have stores around, they probably also brought provisions for their family and friends. And so the Lord started to distribute this fish and bread. Other people also, most likely, were sharing also the little that he had. And that's what we should do. God will multiply many times when we share it to others, the blessings that we have. And this miraculous feeding of the 5,000 signified that God has indeed sent Jesus as the anointed prophet and king, our Savior, to save us all from our sins and the fires of hell. We know that Jesus' feeding of the 5,000 is the only miracle also that was reported or repeated in all 4 Gospels, John, Mark, Luke, and Matthew. And the significance is that this miracle continued to point to God's provision of manna during the time of Moses in the wilderness for the people of Israel. And this daily provision of the barren wilderness foreshadowed the true heavenly bread which Jesus would offer to his followers, to all of us, when we come forward to receive him, body and blood. Jesus makes a claim which only God can make. He said he is the true bread of heaven that can satisfy the deepest hunger in this life that we all experience. The sign of multiplication of the loaves. The Lord says the blessing, breaks the bread, distributes it to his disciples, brings feeders, the sober abundance of the unique bread of his Eucharist at the last supper, or the Lord's Supper, his holy Eucharistic celebration that we share.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty,
Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the 3rd day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We trust in God's generous provision. Let us offer our prayers this day. For the Pilgrim Church on earth, may the Holy Spirit continue to protect her and preserve her. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those in public office, may the Lord bless their efforts to protect the dignity and sanctity of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who hunger for God, and for all who seek to provide them their daily bread, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, as we celebrate the Eucharist, may the Holy Spirit help us grow in unity and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who suffer through chronic or terminal disease, especially Maureen Cody, Helen Voges, Mary and Nate Menges, may they be strengthened through the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who died in the light of Christ, especially Ann Slaw, Stephen French, Ron Ballas, and Greg Eilerick, may they rejoice in the fellowship of the saints in glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And in today's Mass, please remember the intentions of Tony Adorno, for whom this is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all poor souls in purgatory, especially for the souls of our truths in our being, Christo, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And in silence of our hearts, let us pray for our own personal, special intentions. For our community in Auburn and we all be protected from any sickness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And all these prayers and intentions we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that truly powerful working of your praise, this most sacred mystery, may sanctify our present way of life, and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift him up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, good Father, almighty and eternal God, true Christ, our Lord. For through his master mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he had freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen prince, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of God.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Until you come again.
Christ, we will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jaime, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have been to draw the ages, we may never to be coerced to eternal life, and be praised and glorified by you through your Son, Jesus Christ. True and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Drink of his love.
The morning mass on Fridays will be held in the church with adoration following. Confessions will be heard from 9 o'clock to 10 a.m. in the chapel reconciliation room. First Friday adoration will follow the 8:30 a.m. mass on August 6th during the hours of 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Everyone is invited to come throughout the day in quiet prayer before the Blessed Sacrament, ending with benediction at 6 p.m. The hall roof project will be scheduled soon, and you will be kept informed to scheduling any construction detours in the parking area. Our lectern ministry is looking for new volunteers. Tom Fossen is the person to contact.
Good evening. My name is Tom Boston, and I'm the coordinator for the lector ministry here at Century Savannah. If you ever desired or wanted or thought about proclaiming the word before the congregation, please come and see me. We do need additional lectors. We've had some that have left the area in this last year or so, and some that have not come back to the ministry. So we are in need of additional lectors so that we can have more space, more teams for each of the masses that we have. And that would be for all this mass on Saturday evening and the 2 morning masses on Sunday. If you're interested, please come and see me. I have a table out on the plaza after mass is concluded, and I'd be happy to answer any questions that you may have. And thank you for your consideration.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the Passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us in love, beyond all terror, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord with you.
And with your spirit.